Hello, I'm Tadj Oreszczyn. I'm Professor of Energy and Environment at UCL's Energy Institute. I originally trained as a physicist, and then I did a PhD in solar energy. I then worked in consultancy before coming back to academia at UCL. I was lucky enough when I joined UCL to help set up the Energy Institute, and I was its founding director. I've also been lucky enough at UCL to have undertaken most of my teaching and research in multidisciplinary teams. I believe that if we're to solve the biggest global challenges, this requires the knowledge from different disciplines to be brought together. When I'm not teaching, I run large government-funded research projects in energy use in buildings and also how smart meters can transform the energy system. I have a particular obsession with data, particularly data to provide the empirical evidence for what's actually happening in our built stock, and to use that to complement our theoretical understanding. And so with colleagues have developed the field of energy epidemiology. I believe that if we're to prevent the worst effects of climate change, we have to decarbonize the whole energy system in the next 3 decades. Now, doing this is going to be incredibly exciting, but also very, very challenging. It's going to be challenging because we need to change everything at the same time in the energy system. We need to move to using decarbonized supply in buildings at the same time as decarbonized supply in our cars and our industry. And we need to replace our coal, gas, and oil-fired power stations with, for example, wind and solar-generated electricity. Now, balancing the supply with the demand in buildings and transport industry is going to be really tricky. The transition is going to cost billions of pounds and dollars and impact on everybody's lives, their homes, workplaces, and how we move around. Now, you could play a major part in helping to make this transition happen. The good news is that there are many different routes to achieving net zero carbon. Which is the best will depend on many things. For example, the culture and politics. What do we want to do with energy and when? What do we find politically acceptable? It will depend on the climate. Do we need to heat our buildings more than cool them? And how will that change in the future? Does the sun shine when we actually need energy? And there are other national factors, such as how much of the existing infrastructure is already in place and what can we afford to do. Access to innovative smart technologies, better data, and changes to our economic, social, and cultural landscapes will allow us to do this in a smarter way than we have done historically. This is, at its core, an economic, social, and technical challenge. It's this challenge that is core to the course, but particularly the fundamental module that I lead. In the module, we'll be examining the role that buildings play in the future transformation of our energy system, how we can help plan for the local transition in different countries and different regions using smart technologies, smart tools, and business models where appropriate. Thank you for listening, and I look forward to teaching you next year on the Fundamentals module.